தாயாள் திருமகனை போராணை கற்பகத்தை பேணினால் வாராத புத்தி வரும் வித்தை வரும் புத்திர சம்பத்து வரும் சக்தி தரும் சித்தி தரும் தான் சக்தி தரும் சித்தி தரும் தான் சக்தி தரும் சித்தி தரும் தான் சக்தி தரும் சித்தி தரும் தான்
சார் த அக்கேஷன் டுடே இஸ் த டே ஆஃப் ரஷ்யா one of the important key component in BRICS. And we thought our journey should start from one particular point, and then we planned like-minded people. So we decided every month there should be some important occasion in this BRICS. So we will celebrate that. So when we were charting our dates and scheduling, we came on this 12th. It was a Friday, and it was the day of Russia. So it happened to be that, so we started our day today. BRICS generation is going to be a small outfit of people who are not in the upper strata of any diplomatic studies or anywhere directly connected with anything connected with external affairs or fundamentally, we are all common people here who have some interest to countries, relationships, and what we see in foreign countries. And we also aspire, adalang illiye, why it's not here? Are they same thought is with us for the past 20, 25 years of our careers? So we thought we'll start something new, in at least in Tamil Nadu. As a journalist for 25 years, I'm the editor now of Muthukumar and Muthukumar. In the foreign affairs sphere, we have never seen anything very active or vibrant in Tamil Nadu. There are studies, of course, there are various associations, but nothing taking this strategic studies to the common people, the youth, the students, to interest them into this subject. So we thought we'll do some cultural activity in our own way. Anyway, BRICS, most of us, the elite gathering here, knows about BRICS. It's a much talked about subject now. Of course, my presentation will be the origin of BRICS. And I'm not going to dwell more because time is short. It's all there. So I'll just go through it. I'll dwell more on my BRICS generation. Of course, BRICS is acronym, Brazil, Russia, India, China, and South Africa. The term BRIC was coined by Jim O'Neill, economist from Goldman Sachs in 2001. Later on, it became BRICS because, yes, the South Africa joined it somewhere in 2009. In this BRICS, we can assuredly say China and India will become dominant suppliers in the manufacturing goods and services, while Brazil, South Africa, Russia will become a dominant suppliers of raw material. The reason is Russia is abundant with resources like natural gas, petrol, and untold or untapped potential of huge resource of natural reserves. South Africa, gold, diamond, and of course, titanium and other valuable materials. Brazil, commodities, and has got a rich mines and mine wealth, and orange, and so many other natural resources. Apart from this, Brazil, incidentally, before Wright brothers, they experimented in flying And actually their craft flew in Paris and came around the Eiffel Tower. That's history. But what happened later on was, because Wright brothers got the patent and they are the fathers of flying. But right now in the world, third place in manufacturing aircrafts is Brazil. And we have Russia, which is a dominant player in aircraft and aeronautical engineering. So these five countries, of course China is also into component making and parts making. So India is now placed in a very strategic point where they can access to all these people if we continue our relationship in the BRICS. Of course, before BRICS, we have this UN. UN in the early 1940s, before the Second World War, we all know, it was formed to be a platform to make the warring countries come and sit together and talk and chart out the next course of action. Means peace. But warring countries, they have their own difficulties. Finally, they came to the table because of UN. Right now, these five nations in BRICS, we don't have any war or anything. It's all going to be pure trade and other relations. The GDP of all these countries put together is amazing. The human resource wealth is amazing. It's more than 50% of the world's. So these are all figures which are very exciting. That's why Goldman Sachs was so interested in promoting BRICS. Later on, only in 2007, for maybe political reason from Russian side and Chinese side, they started looking at it. But where do India stand? For over 2000 years, India is one country which was peace-loving. We never went into war with any country. In this BRICS, we can play a big role, bigger role, because we are accepted as a superpower. But the world is not going to say accept that. Maybe in 2017, we will be called a superpower. But ultimately, we will have that stigma. They will be calling us a soft superpower because we are not advertising ourselves. So time has come when our leaders, like even the Prime Minister last year, when he went to Brazil for attending this BRICS meet, he forthright said the bank which was planned should be in India, despite our infrastructure. When China had to show and give such places like Shanghai, where things are so big, so huge, we cannot say no to that. So the bank had to be